Welcome back to RUSOMODELS channel. How are you today? Do you feel fine? That's very good. Today we have a wonderful day. After the 45 minutes of the last video about the interior, it looks awesome. If you want to do interior like me, see my video and you enjoy. Also, we finished the engine in the previous video also. Now it's time to work on the chassis. Yes, I know many of you want to know how I make all the things and all the tips and the tricks on the chassis. I'll try to do my best to show you some new things on the chassis, how to use the clamps, how to paint the spring, many tips. Let's start. Enjoy, take a seat, feel comfortable, let's think, let's do the real thing, guys. Really happy, I must say, I really enjoy this kit. It's a very good kit. Highly recommend Tamiya. It's the best company. I all the time say it. But now it's time to start. No more talk. Okay guys, let's start to build the chassis. We will do it with the figure. The first step that we need to do is put the exhaust and the road here over there. I will use a bobsmith glue like I all the time do. I will show you what I'm doing. Put a little bit bobsmith glue, take a toothpick and start working, guys. You love my page because you see me working. This is why you love my channel. So let's do it together with you. Okay, the first step that we need to do is put the metal here, metal rod over there. This is for the brakes. And I try to do my best to show you and work with the camera. Okay, very easy task. We will do it in a couple of parts that you will see and enjoy with me. Okay, I put a little bit glue over there for the exhaust and also over there. Do you see it? And over there. I know that many of you waiting for the end result of this car, but it will take at least more two parts of the video. Okay, I'm going over there and over there. This is the first one, like the drawing say. Yes, we are in the place. I think we are in the place, maybe no. Let's see. Yes, we in the place. Okay, the first one, and this is the second one. Like that. Awesome. Very easy. I know it was easy. Let's continue because we have a long video today. Okay, yes, beautiful people. We can continue. The second steps is put the parts that we are glued before and also the dry shaft with also metal rod over there. Okay, let's start again with super glue. Very informative video. someone sent me, this is a very informative video. You know what is happened to me when people said I really enjoy. I have a big smile on my face that people say this is very informative video. Okay, we take this part and glue it. Don't be scared, just bring it to the place. Try to find the place. Also, okay. Now let's put the metal rod. It's supposed to be over there. Let's see if it's okay. Yes, it's look okay to me. My suggest for you, it's all the time look on the figure, see if you have two holes, like over there. Okay, if you see, you have two holes over there, so be careful and see where it needs to be. Okay, you see, the first hole. Okay,
And also verify the parts go inside before you put the glue, okay? In Tamiya, in Tamiya kits, everything fit amazing. You don't need to fit all the time the parts, but in other kits, unfortunately, not all the parts go inside like you do, yeah, like you want. So keep attention to the details and the manual instruction, and let's continue, okay, guys. This is the dry shaft. You know, it's a rear engine, so it's a need to be in dry shaft. Also, this part we need to glue it. Okay, second step, guys. Second step. I put little bit glue over there, and put little bit over there, and over there, and also over there. I won't verify it. It will sit and stay forever. Okay. Now we can glue the second part. Okay, look what I'm doing, holding, try to find a place like a gloves. Tamiya kits, guys, Tamiya kits, it's amazing. Okay, we have it. Let's continue and see what we have more to do. Okay, we can continue. The third part is to put the spring over there, and also this part that holding the spring and the wheel. Okay, I will show you how I do it, but before it I want to show you some trick on the springs. Imagine that you want to paint only the spring and no inside. What I do, it's called a dry brush. I use a red. You know, in the instructor they say paint it in black, but I want in red, so who can stop me? So what I do, I want to do a painting only on the spring, okay, not inside. So I will show you my technique how to paint in dry brush. I open the bottle, okay, take a little bit from here with a brush. I think this is the first time that you see me painting with brush. It will be nice, okay, but I not paint directly on the spring. I paint first of all on paper, okay, everybody see it, and then I come to the spring and just dry a little bit, okay. You see, you see, this is called dry brush, and then all the spring inside stay in silver, and all the area that I brush stay with black, stay with red, okay. This is called a dry brush. Why a dry brush? Because you don't have many paint on the brush, so it paint only the area that you are in the on the face, okay, the face area of the spring. I hope that you can see it inside stay silver. This is good technique to do it. If you like it, you can try to do it. Look, just put little bit and even little bit touching, okay, and it will paint little bit touching. If you need more paint, put over there and again play with it. Look how it's amazing. Good tip. Now you know how to paint springs. In the instructor say that they say, Tamiya say that paint it in black, but I want it in red. I think it's more awesome and unique. Okay, now we will start connect all the part. Awesome. Do you believe? This is good. Okay, let's continue. I will close the bottle. People, all the time when you're painting, close the bottle, because sometimes you can make a mess on the workbench. So, this is the part that we need to glue. This is the first part that we need to glue, and after that the spring, okay? So I see that it's going over there, so I will put a little bit glue. Right, it fit perfectly. No need to put the glue. Okay, a little bit more Bob Smith gold with a toothpick. Put the place that you want. I all the time use a toothpick because I think it's more delicate. You have more control on the glue. Okay, do you see the two pieces? If you will put the metal rod over there, so you can put the next part. This is very important to see the whole instructor sheet. They tell you how to do with the manual. Okay, super easy. It's very good and helpful. Look, tam ta ta tam. And then you need to take one of them. Okay, you can mistake because they have some circle area, so you can see the figurine and see which one go to where. Okay, this one go here. You need to flip. You need to flip it, and then put it like that, like the drawing say, and then it will be very easy. Okay, you see this one, this one. Okay, you see the angle? Need to go like that. Okay, so what I will do, a little bit Bob Smith over there. It look like I built many cars like that, that I know all the places. But believe me, after you built many models, you also know all the places. Yes, we have it. Don't make a mistake. Put it over there. Sorry, sorry, yes, yes, you will see. Okay, I put it inside and fit perfectly. Do you see? This is the spring. Let's make the other one and we continue. By the way, I paint all the connectors to the wheel in titanium silver, this one. So if you want to paint all the area that you I paint, in which kind of paint, this is the paint that I use. You can use any paint that you want. You don't need to listen all the time to the Tamiya manual. You can do it by yourself and succeed. Okay, we have the spring, the chassis, guys. Let's continue. Okay, we continue the fourth part, how to put the holder for the brakes. Today we will not do the brakes because I've not painted it yet, but we will do it and I will show you. But now let's put the holder with the connector that hold them together, and I will show you what I love to do. It's to first put one of them, okay, like that, and then come from here inside, put it to other area. Look what I'm doing, put it inside, very nice, and push it to this area. Okay, do you see I bend it a little bit and then push it? Awesome. Do you see? Everybody see? First one, okay. Now let's put the other one. I connect it to the connector between them and then push it inside, and also in the same technique, guys. Lift it a little bit and that's it. We finish one more steps, guys. This is the wheel, they moving. Everybody see it? Easy task. Yes. Let's continue. So yes, part number 5, to put the cover of the area of the wheel. We have two. You can make a mistake, guys, you can make mistake, and I show you why. On the two covers they have a small area, so if you want to put it, let's say in this direction, you will cannot put it. You see, because this area it can let you put it inside. They have only one area like that. Everybody see? You can mistake, but you need to glue. You need to glue it very well. So I will see before I will glue. Okay, that it look good to me. Let's put glue over there. Again, I use a bobsmith glue. Bobsmith glue is very good glue. Also for clear parts, so it will be amazing. You see, I put little bit glue. Also the other area. I put little bit more glue because I want this part will be strong. Okay. Now you can mistake, remember? Let's put the cover and see what happened. Yes, awesome. They have only one place that you can go inside. Let's make the other one. Schlack, schlack. Like a Lego. You know, it's very fun to do it and explain you how to do it. You will see the cover. By the way, the brakes we will do later with the 3D wheels. There's a good surprise for you about the wheels, but we will talk it on the next part, on the next video, maybe next Friday. But let's continue. Okay, the next step, as you can see, after we finish all the interior, we need to glue it to this to the chassis. And I will show you what I'm doing. Again, little bit bobsmith. Now it's time to put the interior that we built, the cockpit. Okay, I put a little bit glue, only too much, because if you make any mistake you can remove it. Okay, I take the wonderful the interior that we built in the last video and try to find a place and put it. Okay, like a glove, guys. This is Tamiya kit gloves. Okay, also the next step that you build the engine, tell you, okay, let's put the engine. So we will put also the engine. Okay, let's see where it's going inside. Okay, I see over there we have a two area. I will put on them glue very nice, very gently, and also on these two area. Sorry, I will try that you can see. It's very important, someone you will build this kit. And over there. And let's put the engine. Look, it's amazing engine and it fit like a glove. Okay, play with it to the right position. Try to find it. And verified it's go inside from all direction, here and here and here. Hold it little bit. What happened? Okay, that's good. It look good. That's it. Let's continue, guys. Okay, after the engine is installed, we need to put the drivetrain over there. We have a small one and a big one, and also the part of the airbox. I have it here. You can mistake because look in the engine size. Okay, here we have a big gap. It means they need to put the big one, and over there the lower one. And also you can mistake because here we have it's a F rounded. Okay, so you can mistake when you glue it. Just put glue inside on the static part, remember? It's going to be here, and the other area going to be here. Yes, and then I will try to put it without the tweezers, but I can't. I will take a tweezer and put the other one, but let's put this one. Also, you can mistake, you can put it and bend it and see how it's going inside. Perfect. Okay, let's take with tweezer. Try to not destroy the paint. Also, if you destroy the paint, you can paint it again, it's not a problem. Just focus. I hope that you can see it, but it's going inside perfectly. Drivetrain, guys. Now you need to put this part. I will take a little bit glue and put over there and also over there, and it will stay forever. Okay, here I'm not touching, just put little bit bare metal foil black and paint this in one in titanium silver, and the rest I leave in chrome. This is what Tamiya want us to do. They tell you to paint it in a gloss black, but I put on this small part bare metal foil and that's it. Oh, look, it's get attention. Okay, let's continue. We have these two parts and we need to glue them over there. Let me see how. Yes, like that. Do you see how much easy is? Look, look, super easy, guys, super easy. Believe me, it's wonderful kit. Again, Bobsmith glue. I will put in the two holes and also a little bit on the two holes. My favorite glue, it's, you know which one is it. Yes, I don't need to say it again. Okay, let's put this part. See if everything fit. Awesome. The other area, it's look like a car, no? It start to get in the shape and all the parts, and it look fantastic. One is here. Ta-tam. Believe me, like a glove. Very fun build, very fun kits. Wow. Let's continue. Let's put the intercooler over there. We have two intercooler with the turbocharger. It's a little bit tricky and I will show you how I make it. Yes, guys, yes, the intercooler. Do you see it? We need to do the intercooler. We need to put it over there. Also, you can mistake because over there you have a shape and then you come from here. You can glue them, and over there it's supposed to be inside and then go under. Okay, but before it I want to show you where it's connected over there, like that. Okay, do you see it? It needs to be below and connect to the turbocharger inside. Let me see if you can see it. Okay, do you see here we have a turbocharger? They have a small holes that need to be go inside, but before it I want to show you some magnificent trick. It's not a trick, it's just a clamps by crazy modeler EP0095. Okay, and I show you what I'm doing with this before all the intercoolers and everything. Okay, on this pipe, the air pipe from the intercoolers, I want to add a clamp over there. Okay, I want to add a clamp over there and I will show you how I do it. Okay, let's move it around and take one of the clamp. It, I think, will be okay. Let's say that we will take this one. Okay, I don't know if you can see it, it's a little bit far from you, but I try to do it on camera. Okay, do you see the bend? Now I have this magnificent tool by Harpy Tools. It's amazing. It's a step of the ladder of bending, so it means if you put it over there and bending, okay, and then the clamp will be like that. Okay, do you see the bending? Okay, so now I will take more step of the ladder of bending and start to bend it to the right place that I want. Yes, I take it to myself and you not see. Okay, do you see how I bend it? It's very important that you can see. And then, after it's bending, you take the part. And now I will show you. You take the part, put the bending inside, and try to play with it. Yes. They have a limit of focus to the camera, so try to see what I'm doing. Okay, I put it inside, and then hold the other area and push it. Okay? Try to bring it to the place, and then push it. Push it, and then twist it. Okay? And the remains, I will cut. The remains, I will cut. Okay? And bend it over. And we have a bending. Clamp. Okay? Easy? Very good. Now, the interesting part is to put the part. The interesting part is to put the part. Okay? I need to put a little bit boss meat. I will leave it. I will take a little bit boss meat. Put it inside. Where is the turbocharger? Very informative video. Okay? And take my tweezer and try to bring it the best place that I can put it. Okay? Try to see it. Awesome. This is the hard part on this build, believe me. This is all the hard part in the building. All the building. Okay? And now I will take the intercooler. I will put a little bit bobsmith again. Put a little bit bobsmith on this area over there and also on the pipe. Okay, do you see? And then I will come with the part, this one, and try to put it in the place. Awesome. It fit perfectly. Okay, try to push it a little bit with the cotton swab. See the gaps and everything. Look, we have intercooler. It's a little bit different to see, but you see the clamps? I know, yes, the car will be close and nobody see it, but you see it now. This is what I want to see. That's it, guys. That's it. I will do the other side and we'll continue. Yes, I'm ready to continue. Let's put the springs and the holder for the brakes. Okay, we will do it in a couple of steps. Let's put a little bit bobsmith on this area. And this area. Do you enjoy? So you're still not subscribed to this channel? I hope that you will subscribe after this video. If not, I don't know what to do more. Okay, let's put this place. Very good. Let's see it together. Okay, it needs to put be inside over there and also over there, and it will be fixed. Okay, again, little bit bobsmith to the other area. Over there and over there. Super glue. Everything here is with super glue. It's awesome. Okay, now I put it from inside and then push this down. If it's hard for you, you can use a tweezer, but I think it's okay. For me, let's see if everything okay. Fix. You hear the click? It means it's in place and it looks fantastic. Okay, let's put the spring. Okay, on the spring, you can stay because you have the area that need go inside. This one, I hope that you can see. Okay, the figure is say it need to be go from this area first to the lower area and then to the upper area. You see over there, okay? Fix it here and then go inside. Look what I'm doing. I try to find a place that you go inside. Yes, like that. Okay, again, if you can't do it with the hand, use a tweezer, it's not a shame. Okay, it look good to me, the spring. Okay, so I will put a little bit glue inside. Where is you, my favorite glue? Buy one and let me know. Okay, I will take a little bit Bobsmith glue and put inside over there. Yes, it's a little bit tricky, but it's not too hard. Also over there a little bit. Let's take one and see what happened. Yes, remember, not for me this area. First start with the bottom and then go inside. If you not see it, I will do it again, but I think this one is not real. This one, yes, with the shape. You know, Tamiya make it easy because he all the time show us which part go inside, and you can make mistake, so you can make mistake. Okay, perfect. Okay, let's make the other one a little bit Bobsmith. Over there I will put, and over there inside. Try to see it. And then I will go from bottom and to top. Awesome. Very helpful. Yes, you ready to continue? Let's put this two part, the pipe from the intercooler to the airbox and to the engine. I use also a clamp in same method. I put the three clamps and I will show you how to connect it. Yes, okay, I'm here for you, and now we will put the two pipe that come from the intercooler to the airbox and to the engine. What I'm do, little bit glue over there. No need too much. Let it put. No need to put pressure at all in modeling. Just flow with the parts. And if it's not go inside, so something is not you do something wrong. So no need to put pressure. Okay, guys. The first pipe, it's inside, and I'm very happy. Okay, the second one. Let's put a little bit glue over there. Awesome, awesome. And also over there. And take the other piece. This is very unique style of air intake system. If people don't know, if they don't come from the, if they don't love cars, car lovers, so I will give a little bit explanation about turbocharger and the intercooler and why we need it. The engine create gases that spin the turbocharger, but from the spinning of the turbocharger, the air is too high, in high temperature, so we need to cool it down. And this is why we need the two intercooler, and then the air come from here to this area and then to the cylinder head, and then come back from gases and again and again and again. This is all the circulation. So all the car with the turbocharger, they put the intercoolers that to create a low temperature for the air that go inside to the engine. And this is the lesson that I learned and you also now. I hope that I explain it well. But look, wow, all the system with the turbocharger and everything, and it's look fantastic. Now you see everything here, all the things, nothing. You will not see nothing. Why Tamiya, why you do it? Because we will put the cover. The cover, okay, but this is the part of the build. So you can enjoy and build it, but after that you will not see it. If you won't see it, see my video. Okay, let's continue. Yes, you are with us. 16 parts. We need to put the two cover and this part. I don't know what is it. If some of you know, let me know. But it's here and I need to put it. Okay, let's put the cover. Also in the cover you can make mistake because we have two clips. And if you take it to the right position, it will not go inside fixedly. So if I take this one to here, you will see what happened. You see, it's not going inside until the area. Well, let me show you. You see here, it's not going inside. So you need to verify what you do and which one is going inside. Okay, before the glue and everything. But now that we know each part go inside, we can put a little bit glue over there and over there, and also to the other area. Take one and put it. You see, this is not the place. I will take it out and put it over there and it will sit perfectly. Okay, also over there. Awesome. Believe me, you don't need too much glue, just little bit. Okay, now this part that I don't know what is it, maybe some of you know, I need to put it over there like that. Believe me, we don't need to put a glue. Okay, this is a part that we need to put little bit over there and over there. Super. This one. Leave me a comment if some of you know what is this part. Maybe it's electric engine, I don't know. Okay, also the tamiya said that we need to put paint it in X80 all the part. I don't know what is it. I put little bit silver here to demonstrate something, and let's see what we have to do more. Yes, now the cover. Tamiya, why we need to put the cover? We want to see all the beauty. Okay, now they say we need to put the cover and also the rear window. Okay, like that. So do it like a pro. By the way, the cover, I use a carbon fiber sticker and it looks fantastic. Also we have some mesh here, and now we will glue this part first. Yes. You enjoy. Okay, I put a little bit over there and put it a little bit over there. Remember that I say nobody see the seat belts. This is the meaning, because this one covers the seat belts. Okay. Oh, what happened? The speaker flew up. This is the speaker for Moby Design. It's going out. Let's put it together. Because it's a little bit higher. Yes, awesome. I love more metal parts from decals. Tamiya sent put the decals over there, but I think it's more nice and beauty when you have the real metal part. I hold it for 5 seconds and leave. Hold it and leave. Okay, we're about to finish this video. Yes, I feel shame that I need to put it. Okay, let me see if all go well. Yes, like a gloves. Guys, it's amazing. Wow, it's amazing kit. Okay, let's see. I need to put a little bit glue over there. So I will put over there a little bit. and over there a little bit, and also in these two points. Okay, be careful of the clear window. Do it slowly and put the cover. Bye bye engine. Okay, see if it's going inside perfectly over there and over there, and everything sit perfectly. Yes, awesome. Awesome. Guys, we beat all the chassis. All the chassis today with you. Long video, but we have everything. Look, it's amazing. All the exhaust, all the intercooler pipes with clamps, the cylinder, the spring, everything. Everything, it's everything. It looks fantastic, guys. Wow. Carbon fiber look. I put a decal of a carbon fiber and then paint it with a matte finish look. And wow, look, all the covers and the engine. This is what we built today. Yes. So what I can tell you about this kit? You see me enjoy from every step that I do. I enjoy a lot. On the next video, we will put, I think, the brake system and also the wheel. And after that, we work on the body because we have a lot of part of to put on the body, the headlights, the tail lights, some air vent. So it will be very nice. I hope you enjoyed today. I know that many of you want to see me finish this build and start one more, but I try to take it in my time and do it the best way that I can do for you. And I hope that you can see that each time that I build model, I all the time improve in the film and painting and everything. And it's up to you to tell me what to you see me build. Okay, so no need to talk. This is nice and that's it. Have a good day. Bye bye, RUSOMODELS channel.